All right, guys, we're back staring at my engine bay, and in this video we are going to be talking about the best hybrid turbo options for your B58 engine. And this is something that we talked about a little over a year ago, and I just wanted to make an updated guide because we've had a lot of new turbos come out and a lot more data with the existing turbos. So I feel like this is a good opportunity to talk about, you know, all the data we've seen, what kind of power you can expect, and what kind of limitations you'll see with hybrid turbos. So let's go ahead and hop into the video. So first things first, we'll talk about what a hybrid turbo is and why you would pick it. And basically, a hybrid turbo is a stock location turbo that looks just like the stock turbo. So it fits like stock, it'll bolt up to the stock intake, charge pipe, downpipe, all of that will fit just like the stock turbo. And so this is a really good option for people that have, you know, inspections, especially everybody that's in Europe. And you have to worry about, you know, emissions or anything where somebody could be looking at your engine bay and you could potentially get a fine for having an aftermarket turbo. It's also nice if you just want to have a sleeper setup, you know, and when people pop the hood and kind of look at it from this point of view, they might not have any idea that something is upgraded. You'd really have to dig into there to see that it's an upgraded turbo. But what companies typically did in the past was they took your stock turbo and machined it and bored it out. So that way they could fit a bigger, higher flowing wheel inside the stock housing. And then when you reinstall it, you'd have a lot more power capacity. But nowadays, a lot more companies are coming out with complete replacement turbos. So they look like stock and, like I said, fit just like stock, but it's a brand new cast manifold, a brand new turbo housing, the wheels and everything are provided to you. So you don't have to provide your stock turbo to be modified. And you don't have to pay an extra core fee to send your turbo back. So that's a really nice option that makes it an even better value. And hybrids were already much cheaper than, you know, full frame aftermarket kits. So it makes it an even more viable option. A lot of people prefer modifying a stock turbo over a completely brand new unit because maintaining more of the stock components helps maintain reliability. You know that everything's going to be in spec and it's going to fit well. Versus a lot of the companies that are casting their own manifolds, people question, you know, where those manifolds are coming from and what kind of quality you can expect. So it's really just up to you, basically, what you trust. Both seem to have a good track record on the B58, but with a modified stock turbo, you kind of know what you're getting. With a brand new unit, a lot of people question, you know, the sources. Now, the primary limitation to hybrid turbos is the horsepower capacity. And the options for the B58 are generally capped around 700 wheel horsepower. They just don't have the efficiency needed to run more than that. So with the stock size runners and things like that, you kind of lose efficiency really quickly when you're really trying to push for higher horsepower. I'd say most of the turbos are really happy around 600 to 650, but I have seen a couple dynos where people, you know, add port injection and really push it as hard as they can, and they get in the 700s. They're also good for mid to low 10 second quarter miles. Most of the people that I see pushing it on, like, you know, stock cars with full weight and everything are getting a best around 10.2 to 10.3. There are a couple of people running like 10.0s or even in the 9s, but typically they have some weight reduction, you know, maybe removing the seats. Some people are using nitrous on top of the turbo to get a little bit more push. And also a lot of them are running at the track. So, you know, they're on a radial, on a prep drag strip with good conditions, and that can get you, you know, a 10.0 or even a high 9. So depending on your goals, this might be the perfect option for you. A lot of people do this just for simplicity's sake. You know, if you already have an intake and an aftermarket downpipe, you can swap your turbo and reinstall all those parts, and it will fit just like it did before. Also, from a reliability perspective, generally they have been pretty reliable. Even companies that people have concerns with from like the N54 days have been providing reasonably reliable turbos. So I think that's a really great option for anybody with a B58. Keep in mind, any turbo can fail. I've seen failures across the board. Different ones have had, you know, damaged wheels, oil leaks, damaged wastegates, you know, a lot of different scenarios. So even if a turbo has a really good track record, make sure you're buying from a company that you trust so that even if you're in that 1%, you know that, you know, you'll be covered and the company will treat you right. So now we'll go ahead and talk about the different options and my recommendations. Keep in mind that all of these companies don't make options for all generations of the B58, so you might need to do a little more research to make sure your specific engine is covered. But these turbos are mostly marketed for Gen 1 folks, so they don't have as many options for the Gen 2. So the first one that I want to talk about is the Dynamic AutoWorks Flow Max. And this is probably the newest one on the market right now. And a lot of people are wondering why there's so much hype. You know, does it really perform that much better than the other options and things like that? And basically, the main reason why people like it is the value. So these come in at a much lower price compared to the competition, solely because they provide an entire turbo unit. So you don't need to send your core in. They're not modifying turbos. They're providing their own cast manifolds and wheels and everything so that you can just install it. And if you want to, you can sell your stock turbo to get a little bit of your money back. Now, this turbo does have a good track record for reliability on the B58. A lot of people are making really good power. It spools very quickly. So this is the one that I typically recommend to people. I know a lot of folks just bought it on Black Friday, so you guys should be helping us get even more data. Hopefully, we see more dynos and more draggy times to understand how well these cars perform. But yeah, I would say they perform pretty similarly to the other Stage 2 hybrid options at a much better price. So definitely check them out. Feel confident if you're buying from them. The owner is active on the forums and in the different groups, so I definitely feel like that's a good company to work with. My next recommendation is a Vargas GC, and I like this turbo because it is extremely reliable and even cheaper than the Flow Max. However, it is only a Stage 1 hybrid, so it doesn't support as much power as the Stage 2, like full hybrid turbos, but it will still provide a good amount of power. A lot of people are getting between 550 to 600 with good fueling, so it doesn't modify anything in the manifold. It doesn't modify the wastegate. You know, you're basically just putting a new wheel in the stock housing. So it's a really, really good value proposition if you're not shooting for a lot of power. Maybe you're on 93 octane and you just want to push the car a little bit harder without completely upgrading your hybrid. It's just a good value option, and I see a lot of people making good numbers with this as well. If you're pushing it on good fuel, you get in the mid to high tens pretty easily, so I definitely think that this is a good option for a lot of people. Personally, I have not been recommending the Vargas GC Plus, and that is their full Stage 2 hybrid turbo. The reason why I don't recommend it is because it hasn't been performing as well as the competition. The ones that I've seen just don't have logs that are as good, and they don't make as much power as the other Stage 2 hybrids. So if you're going with a Vargas turbo, stick with the GC. If you want a Stage 2 hybrid, I typically recommend going with one of the other options. Now, next, we're going to talk about one that isn't actually as popular in the US, but it's very popular in Europe, and that's the Turbo System Stage 2. And Turbo Systems is a company that makes hybrids across a lot of different platforms, and their Stage 2 offering for the B58 has been making a lot of power and making really good products. So I think these turbos are a little bit underrated over here, just maybe not as many people have heard of them, but over time they're going to get a lot more popular. We've seen some big dyno numbers in the 700 wheel horsepower range and getting in mid to low tens as well. So I think this is just another viable option that people haven't heard about, but it has a very good price. It does have a core charge with it, but it's still a little bit cheaper than some of the other options out there. So I think, you know, if you're willing to sell your turbo back to them or send your turbo back, this is one of the cheaper options that still uses that process where they actually modify your existing turbo. And yeah, I just think it's another good option that a lot of people in the US aren't aware of. So definitely check out the Turbo System Stage 2. They're actually coming out with an updated version that flows a little bit more air and it's a little bit more efficient. So hopefully that'll be on the market soon. Now, the last one we're going to talk about is the Pure 800. And this is kind of like the tried and true, you know, the biggest known name in the B58 world for hybrid turbos. They have been making hybrids for a long time over a lot of different platforms, and they have an extremely good track record. People know what to expect when they order from Pure. But it is the most expensive option, and that's really the biggest downside. You're going to be paying the most for it. You are going to have a core charge, or you are going to have to send out your turbo to have it modified. But the turbo works. You know, the Pure 800 is an extremely solid option. A lot of people are running it and having really good results. Same deal, you know, 700 wheel horsepower range, mid to low tens, depending on how hard you push it. So I still think that this is a good option. Now, two things that I want to mention. First of all, there is also a Pure 850, and a lot of people wonder if they should wait on the Pure 800 and instead get an 850, or if they have a Pure 800, should they upgrade to an 850? And long story short, those turbos are not very different. It has, I think, like a 3 millimeter larger compressor wheel, so it can flow a little bit more air, but don't expect it to be a significant improvement over your Pure 800, especially if you haven't completely maxed it out. That's the only point where the 850 will give you any kind of gains. But if you're in that 600 to 650 range, like most people, upgrading to an 850 won't really make a difference. Now, the other question I get a lot is about the Pure Stage 1, and this turbo is not on the market. They do not sell it anymore. And no, I have no idea why it's still on their website, but I've seen this multiple times where they say that they don't sell it anymore, so it's not really an option. If that's something that you're interested in, then your best bet is the Vargas GC. That will give you similar performance to what the Pure Stage 1 used to perform like when they did sell it. It actually probably performs a little bit better than the Pure Stage 1 did. But at this point, it's not an option anymore. They don't sell it anymore, so just take that one off the table and ignore it if it's on the website. So those are the hybrid turbo options that I recommend. There are going to be more coming out this year, and I've already seen teasers from a couple different companies. So keep your eye out for new offerings. Keep your eye out for more and more data as people try them out. And hopefully this will just continue to push the BMW aftermarket to get bigger and better options. So thanks again for watching. I hope this video helps. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. Do 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 do